Hi, my name is Daniel Io, part of Perfect Seventh, and in this video we're going to show four ways you can display real-time MIDI chords as you play live in Cubase. So the first way is using the chord track. So I'm going to right click on the project window and select add chord track, but we're also going to need the instrument track for this, so I'm going to add that as well and just use halion 7 as the instrument of choice. Just using a single instrument and just selecting a preset. Okay, so we've got some sound. Gonna need the monitor button enabled for this as well. So let me right click and select the draw tool so I can draw a chord on the chord track. Get the object selection tool to double click on the chord and start playing. So you can already hear we're getting visual feedback, but also an interpreted sound of the chord that I'm playing. And I don't want that interpreted sound. Muting doesn't solve this either. So yeah, still hearing that sound. So this is the least practical for my use case, but you may find some use in this. The second way is using the key editor I'm recording. So I'm going to get rid of this chord track and just deselect the monitor button. And let's get that draw tool. I'm going to draw in a MIDI event, and one must make sure that the recording editor button is active in the lower editor pane, and just make sure that the window layout has the status line ticked. So if I now start recording, so we are getting the chord display. I'll stop now. So the only caveat, of course, is you have to be recording in order to get this visual feedback of live MIDI chords, which may not always be ideal. So the third way, of course, is using a third-party plugin. So if I right click and get the instrument track, this time we'll use Scaler 2, which has the ability to, as you'll see, not only showcase the chords, but showcase the notes as well. Which is handy. Now, if you don't want to purchase a third-party plugin, there is still a way to achieve a similar behavior in terms of the chords, and that's using the context gate. So if I go back to halion and put it as an insert, I'll minimize the polyphony to 3 and start playing. So we are getting that visual feedback. The only issue is if I'm playing two notes, I'm not getting anything because it's not allowing any notes to be generated until it sees 3 at a time, and that's based on the minimum polyphony. So this isn't ideal as a MIDI insert. It should be a MIDI send. Now, using an instrument track, you can't use a MIDI send, but we can use a MIDI track and set the monitor button on for this. And you know, let's just get the context gate as an insert because this isn't intended to be heard. I'll reduce the polyphony to 3. And if we now go back to halion. So we are getting that visual feedback, which is what we've wanted. We can compare this to Scaler 2 as well, because by using it as a MIDI track, you can get the live chords from any instrument track that's active. So let me enable it. We're getting the feedback on not only Scaler 2, but of course on the context gate as well. So I find Scaler is a little more accurate. So there you have it, four ways. Like if this has been helpful, and subscribe for more. Take care.